Hello, I'm Denise Galone. Several years ago, I decided to start my own home-based business. I had so many wonderful women help me along the way. I had the idea for this show, Empowering Women, so I can introduce you to some of those women so they can help inspire and empower you to live your best life. Today, my guests are Holly Earl, owner of The Earl Effect, and Jacqueline Capitola, the owner of Jacqueline's House of Beauty Salon and Spa. I hope you enjoyed today's episode. My guest is Holly Earl, the owner of The Earl Effect. Hi, Holly.
Hi, Denise.
Thank you so much for being here today.
It is my pleasure.
Can you tell the audience a little bit about your background? It's kind of interesting.
Well, it is. You know, for the last 20 years, I have been a licensed cosmetologist, but before that, I've sold everything, you know, under the sun, from cars to photography.
Wow.
I've managed nightclubs. I managed video stores. But more importantly, I'm a people pleaser. I like customer service and I like to make people happy. I think I've been what they call a serial entrepreneur rather than an accidental entrepreneur. An entrepreneur to me means somebody that puts themselves at risk. And I've mostly had commission-based business, so my pay has been based on my performance.
Okay. And you were a cosmetologist.
Yep. And about a decade ago, I decided, you know, it was busy, 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 busy. And I decided I could do this better on my own, in people's homes, at the convenience of their hours, in their home.
That's nice.
You know, sometimes it would be stay-at-home moms. You know, we do it during nap time, but they could still get their laundry done. They could prepare for dinner. And sometimes it's just busy executives that just, they don't have time to get to the salon.
Right.
And then it evolved. I realized that being in their home, I could see that they needed help in many different areas. Whether that's just a little bit of meal prep here or a little bit of mental prep there, emotional reassurance everywhere. And so that's how I evolved my business into The Earl Effect, which is an executive concierge service.
So you didn't start out thinking, I want to be an entrepreneur. It just kind of led that way.
It just led that way. You know, I believe that there was always something more, and I didn't like to conform to my boss's rules. I've always marched to the beat of my own drum, and that was really hard, you know?
I think there's a lot of people that may be watching that agree with that, mm-hmm. And it's kind of hard to do. So The Earl Effect, it's like a concierge service. What exactly does The Earl Effect do? Can you give some examples of your services?
Well, we have three different divisions. So I have a balanced life division where I talk about diet, nutrition, fitness, emotional health, because I believe that no matter what you're taking care of, if you have those things under control, the other things can fall into place, you know.
So, go ahead. A question about that. So does that mean that you help them with meal planning or nutrition wise, or mm-hmm. what do you do?
Yes.
What services do you offer?
I have a meal prep service where we actually go into your home. So you shop, I chop.
Okay.
So you do the grocery shopping, and now it's so much easier with these other services that deliver.
Right.
So you could place the order. It comes at a certain hour. I show up. I prepare, you know, clean, chop, portion, and prepare some meals. So you can come home and be involved with the family.
Okay.
Back to making memories instead of being like, get out of there. Rah!
Right.
You know.
Okay.
And so, and that's my biggest one is the meal prep in service. But I do accountability for if you just are like, I just need a little tweaking. You're mm-hmm. like, let's just sit down and chat.
Yeah.
See what you are eating, what maybe we could adjust, that kind of thing. And then I do the diet, the nutrition education, as well as fitness instructions.
Okay, so that's one part of your business.
Mm-hmm. And then a beauty, I do the in-home services. So whether that's you're a busy executive, a stay-at-home mom, or you're a bride, an event, somebody that has an event, you need your hair and makeup done,
mm-hmm.
we have people that come and do that. We have continuity as far as your brand image or helping you with personal styling.
Okay.
And then the last is it's one that I geek out of. It's the business portion. I don't know what it is. I'm not real OCD, but I like to check out numbers and make people make more money, because when you have more money, you have less stress.
So you like spreadsheets?
Yeah, I do. I'm kind of when I'm stressed out, I like to balance my checkbook. Yeah,
okay.
Weird.
I don't know. Some people might agree with that, Holly, but okay.
You know, but it all gets back to generating more income. And like I said, if you have more income, you have less stress.
And that brings me to my next question. Mm-hmm. You and I have talked before, and we talked about having a side hustle. Mm-hmm. Can you explain what a side hustle is? Because some people may not know that term. Mm-hmm. And what you do for your side hustle, or what you advise people to do with your affiliate links.
Well, a side hustle to me is when you are doing something just on the side that earns a few coins here and there that allows you to do that extra thing to make memories. You know, yes, you're making money, but the ultimate goal is so you can make more memories with your family, with your husband, what have you. And with affiliates, I like them, especially because like Amazon affiliate is one of my favorites. Everybody goes to Amazon. Oh, you could get that at Amazon.
What is an affiliate?
In case anyone's unsure. An affiliate is, we'll say a referral.
Okay.
So if I have a product that I have found on, well, like I said, Amazon, and I say, Denise, you have to have this.
Right, and we do that
and
all the time.
You know, you've referred, oh my gosh, I have this gadget that I use all the time. You should get it. You know, right. You could get it on Amazon. And then you say to yourself, they should pay me for this. Amazon will. They will actually give you 4% and then increasing depending on how many people you're sending to the site. So if you're a busy mom and you're using this one washcloth and everyone's like, oh my gosh, I love that thing. Where'd you get it? You go to Amazon, you type in this washcloth, you sign up, and they give you an affiliate link under you. So it's a code or a referral code.
So you give
that,
our own.
You get your own and you give that to your friend. When they go to Amazon, they click that link, Amazon's like, oh, thank you for sending them my way. We're going to pay you a little bit. We're going to put you some money in your pocket.
Okay.
Now, what I love about Amazon more than the other companies is they do a cart. It's a cart purchase. So say you went to buy those wash rags, mm-hmm. but then you also wanted those shoes and you needed to buy that other gift.
Yeah.
You get a percentage of the cart.
Not just the washcloth.
Okay. And it's a 24-hour cookie, so you can continue to make money.
Okay.
And for busy people, any people, this is something you're doing anyway. Mm-hmm. You're saying, oh my gosh, I love this lipstick, blah, 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 I bought it here.
We just did that before we started.
Exactly, right? So it might be a friend.
Yeah.
And I'm sure that they have, you know, we've heard of bird dogs and things. It's the same thing. Target offers. Every company out there offers an affiliate opportunity. You just have to sign up.
Holly, this might be the first time that people are even hearing about this.
Mm-hmm.
Can you give them a couple tips if they're thinking, maybe I should try that, maybe I shouldn't? Just a couple things they should think about before they try this.
Couple tips. I would.
Or how they should get started.
Make a list of things that you use all the time that you tell. Five things that you tell people all the time, whether that's a book, a gadget, some strainer in the kitchen, what have you. And make a list of those five things and find out where you buy them.
Okay.
And then go to that site and say, hey, do they have an affiliate opportunity? Most all of them should be free. Okay. That would be something. Don't pay to become an affiliate.
Okay, that's an important point.
Yeah, don't.
It's not going to cost me anything up front to do this.
No, this is nothing out of pocket.
Okay.
You type in. Now, there are companies. There's one called Commission Junction that they have become an affiliate. So they gather all the companies out there and say, hey, buy through us. We pay you.
Okay.
You know, but That would be my biggest thing, is just don't pay to be an affiliate.
Okay. And that's important, because people may think, well, mm-hmm. I need to pay that. That's
yes.
normal.
And then the next thing when they fill out, they'll ask, do you have a website or an email list? You don't need them.
Okay.
You know?
That might turn some people off, too, thinking, I'm a stay-at-home mom. I don't have any of these things.
Mm-hmm. Because most likely, you do have an Instagram account. You might have a Pinterest account. Both of those give you an opportunity to stick in a link somewhere. So if you're using, you take a picture, my kids and I are using this thing, look at this bath bomb, we bought it, blah, blah, blah. You put it on your Instagram, you can get it, buy a link in bio, mm-hmm. and boom, you know.
Sounds easy.
Mm-hmm. It is. It's so much easier and less fearful than what you think.
Well, you have so many great tips and ideas. Is there a place that people can go to get some resources that you offer?
Sure. You could go right to my website at hollyearle.com. Okay. And I've put together a PDF for this particular program. So just go to hollyearle.com/empoweringwomen. Oh. And you'll get a few pages of an actual book that I've put together called The Social Media Guide.
Oh, that's awesome. Thank you.
Oh, my
pleasure.
Everybody
needs to go and check that out. Mm-hmm. So what's next for Holly Earle?
Well, I'm actually enrolled in a corporate consultations course, which I'm going to take this where I'm helping individuals, mm-hmm. and I'm going to go to businesses, and I'm going to teach them how to increase their income because they're losing coins too. That's what's next for
me.
And
we could all use some extra income.
Exactly.
Any final thoughts you want to share with the audience?
You don't have to live by the definition that society sets. Meaning, society says all hairstylists have to work in salons. All moms have to stay home and take care of their kids. That's not necessarily the case. You can live a life that you love, doing the things that you love. You just have to think outside the box.
That's wonderful. Thank you for coming on, Holly, and sharing this information. I know I was unfamiliar with it. That's why I was so interested when you were talking about it. I know it's helpful for people watching that may need that little bit of extra income.
Mm-hmm.
Like you said, once you get that affiliate link and put it on maybe your Instagram, that's pretty much all you do, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah. You just put it up there. You say, this is what I got. This is where I bought it. Here's the link. And let it go. And you do it while you sleep.
Thank you. Thank you for the resource.
Oh, it is my pleasure. Thank you.
I'm with my friend Jacqueline Capitola, the owner of Jacqueline's House of Beauty Salon and Spa, located in the Grant Building downtown. Hi, Jackie. Thank you for being here.
Thank you so much for having me.
I'm so excited that you're here. This is the second time you've been on my show.
Yes.
You were on last November, December.
I was.
Mm-hmm. Can you remind the audience a little bit about your background?
Yes, sure. So I've been in the beauty industry, the salon industry, for 35 years or so. I started when I was 15, 16 years old, shampooing, and just have grown ever since. So I've had the salon now for 25 years. Came full circle back down working in downtown Pittsburgh where I started when I was 15, 16 years old. So it's nice to be back downtown.
So it did come full circle, didn't it?
It has.
And you're celebrating a special anniversary, as you said, 25 years.
25 years this year in business.
That's amazing.
Yes, I'm so excited.
Congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah, it's a big accomplishment.
It is a big accomplishment. There's a lot of competition, I'm sure, out there for salons.
There's a lot of competition. You know, I've just always... I've never worried about that. That's one thing that it's there, and I love collaborating with other salons and doing things with other salons and working together and learning from other salons and other people in this industry. There's so much to learn, so much that you can be, you know, keep growing and evolving. So I don't worry about that. I've never have. That's just one thing I've never worried about.
And then since you've been on my show,
mm-hmm.
People may recognize you. You also have your own show here on Bethel Park TV.
I do. Thanks to you.
You want to tell me about your show?
Well, that came from when Denise and I were doing her show, which was not too long ago, a year or so ago. We decided that Jacqueline's Inside Out might be a nice fit. I had, you know, approached and we talked about doing a show about beauty, health, wellness and inspiration, and that's what the show is all about. We do segments and episodes that are geared towards the beauty industry, helping women to feel beautiful, men, whoever, anybody, children, teenagers, to feel beautiful inside and out. So that's what it's all about, just to teach you and share some tips and tricks about anything from the beauty industry to fashion to you know, makeup, hair, things like that we focus on for the show.
It is a great show because it is important
for
people to realize that it doesn't matter what you look, everyone's beautiful in their own way.
Yes, and that's exactly what I want to portray. I want the show to be about just everyday people, not people that, you know, I mean, we're all everyday people, of course, but just, you know, I want it to be a show that focuses on how everyone can feel beautiful, no matter what, you know, and you don't have to think that you have to be that cover model or that, you know, that New York runway model. I mean, we're just all doing our thing, and we all have beauty within us, and I just want to help people to see that.
I think, Jackie, that's an excellent point, because sometimes we see these ads in magazines, mm-hmm. and we think, oh my gosh, she's so beautiful.
Yes.
And it's a lot of it's hair and makeup and yes. a lot of time to yeah. look that way.
Yeah.
I'm sure they don't wake up looking that
no,
way.
No, I mean, they are beautiful, of right. course, you know, but yes, I mean, they have a team around them to do the hair, to do the makeup, to, you know, put on the fashions, to help them to, you know, to look that like they do. And sometimes things are Photoshopped, sometimes mm-hmm. they're not, sometimes they are. So it just really just depends on what beauty is to you, what you see as beautiful. You know what I mean? There's so many different ways that you can look at beauty, and it doesn't have to just be this glamorous thing. You know, just seeing what people do in the world and the kindness and the love and, you know, that kind of stuff is really what makes a person beautiful.
And your show just celebrated its 1-year anniversary.
Yes, it did. So we've had a complete year of inspiration and beauty for Jacqueline's Inside Out. I've learned a lot because I've never done this before, but it's been a very nice learning experience, and I'm just so excited. I think that each time we grow with it, you know, it's fun, it's exciting. And we have a lot of, you know, time together where we figure this out, you know, because it's like, I didn't go to school for any of this kind of stuff, you
right,
know.
Right.
I went to school for what I'm teaching and showing, so I'm very comfortable with that. But being behind the camera is something that's foreign, and you have to get used to that. But it's been a lot of fun, and I've enjoyed it.
Oh, I'm so proud to be your producer of
Thank
your show.
You. And yes, I love having you as my producer. It's just so great to have the relationship, you know,
yes.
that we can draw from each other and help each other, and you know, just stuff like that. So it makes it fun.
And what I really like about your show and the tips that you give, you give easy tips.
Yes.
Nice, easy things that someone could just go home and just do tomorrow morning when they're getting ready for work. Nice,
yes.
easy tips.
I do.
The fashions aren't outrageous fashions. It's just, like you said, for everyday people can
right.
wear.
I think because I've been working with people behind the chair for, like I said, 30-some years, like showing my age or telling my age when I do that, but that's okay. I think what happens is I'm around like moms and, you know, just people that are out working and lawyers and judges, maybe sometimes things like that. But I'm around people that are just stay home moms or
right.
people that are working at the grocery store or, you know, people, waitresses or whatever. I mean, that's what I do. That's who's on our chair every day. So these are the people that I want to attract. These are the people that I want to teach and show. Maybe somebody that's sitting at home watching Bethel Park TV that don't know how to do a smoky eye or didn't know how to curl their hair, you know, the proper way. I just want to appeal to them. I'm not trying to appeal to hairdressers and teach them things, you know.
Right.
I mean, of course I am. I mean, if they're watching, and that's great. And if they're being inspired, that's wonderful too. That's part of Jacqueline's Inside Out mentoring to the students and the stylists in the industry. But for the show, you know, it's just to show everyday things for people to just feel better and little tips to help you succeed.
Yeah. And everyday styles, everyday tips to use your makeup, and doesn't
yeah.
have to be. If someone can't afford the pricey makeup, it doesn't matter. As long as you show them the correct way to do it and make
right.
a difference.
Yeah, that makes a difference. And I know you were a guest on my show not too long ago.
I was.
So we showed some, you know, little fun little tips with that. We curled your hair we did waves with a flat iron. So that was fun. And I know that was kind of foreign to you.
It was. It's a lot
that.
Easier being in this chair than
yeah,
sitting in that chair.
But it was fun.
It
and
was
you
fun.
Did such a great job. So that
Thank
just
you.
Shows that, you know, you can do this. You know what I mean? You can feel that it's the confidence that it brings. I think whenever you feel good on the outside with your hair and your makeup and, you know, you and your clothes of what you're wearing, you feel better and you feel more confident. So you can step outside in the world and you can, you know, take on the world and just whatever it is that you're doing. Even if you're just working at McDonald's or you're working at the library or you're working, you know, wherever. I mean, at the bakery shop, it doesn't matter. Just as long as you feel good and
And we all want to feel good.
Yeah. Yeah. Or if you're that runway model and you're that, you know, it doesn't matter. It's just the way that you need to portray yourself, you know. So
So 25 years, your salon, 1 year for your show.
Yes.
What's next for Jacqueline Capitola?
Oh, this year, I think I'm trying to focus a lot on just really promoting the 25 years. So I have a few things up my sleeve to do for that. We're trying to come up with some different ways to, you know, celebrate that. And not just celebrate my anniversary, but I'm hoping to collaborate, you know, with some people and celebrate other milestones that they're having as well, so that we can come together and show that, you know, we can do this. And whether it's 5 years, 10 years, 15, 25, whatever, that we can come together and show some, you know, some great success that we have had over the years. Because it's not easy to do all this. You know, there's a lot of ups and downs. It's fun and you enjoy it and it's something you're passionate about. But, you know, it always has its ups and downs and stuff like that. But you just keep fighting through them. So, you know, I'm just happy to be able to do that this year. I'm trying to expand with, you know, hiring some new people in the salon and having some new, you know, like positions for the salon and things like that. So that's a lot of where I'm headed. And then as far as the show, I love doing the show. I want to continue to do the show. And I hope that our audience continues to grow and we have, you know, just a lot of fun and people are really learning and being inspired. So that's everything right there pretty much
that's
for this year.
That's a lot.
Yeah.
And Jacqueline's Inside Out and Empowering Women may be collaborating on something soon. So
yes.
We don't want to give too much information away.
No.
That's going to be a little bit of a secret.
That is a little bit of a secret, and that's why I was kind of just touching on it. I didn't know if you wanted to expand, but
no, we'll keep that a secret.
Right, that's going to be a nice little fun secret for this year. So,
well, I'm so glad you were able to come on the show again for a second time.
Yeah, it's been fun. Yeah. I love it. I enjoy it. I always love talking to you, Denise.
Oh, and I love being your producer and seeing you grow with your show and just your friendship. I know we bounce a lot of ideas off each other, which is great, because sometimes it gets lonely being an entrepreneur.
It does. And sometimes you need that. You need that, you know, that friendship. You need that somebody there to just understand, you know, things or realize what it is that you go through, you know. Right. And it's nice to have that. There's just so many things going on in the world today, and it's nice to be able to have people to talk with and help and, you know, grow with. So it's a lot of fun.
And if anyone's interested in the services at your salon, they can go on your website. I'm sure they're listed there.
Yes, we have a website. It's JacquelineSalonAndSpa.com. We're on Facebook. We're on Instagram, so you can check us out there. You can see everything that we offer. We are full service. We offer everything from hair, nails, makeup, fashions, you know, accessories, things like that. We do waxing, and we do pedicures, and we do facials. So we do a lot. We have a nice, it's a small salon. It's not huge, but you know, sometimes that's just as good. Like you can really do a lot in your small space. So, but a lot of my prouder moments are like going out and helping and doing things and, you know, being involved in the community.
Did something for Make-A-Wish.
We did for Make-A-Wish, which I've done that every year at Christmas time, which is really nice. We do a Make-A-Wish makeover on a young teen. She comes in and we do fashions and makeup and hair for her. And then she gets to have a photo shoot, which is really fun. And she gets to team up with some of the models that I use for different things. I invite them to come in and kind of be her little, you know, assistant for the day, and they help her, and they, you know, they show her some moves and things like that. And I tell you what, this little girl this year, she was amazing. Actually, Bethel Park TV had filmed it, so you can go back and check it out on Dave Cable channel for YouTube, and you can look it up. It's the holiday edition for Make-A-Wish. You'll see it. And she was just, she was such a sweetheart, this little girl. Yeah, her name's Caitlin, and her and her mom were there, and her grandma. And I just love when they bring their family members too, because, well, of course, they have to come with them. They're little, you know, they're teenagers. And their family members are just so excited as well, you know. Mm-hmm. They're excited to see their little girl, like, have fun and enjoy the night. And I tell you what, when they come in at the beginning, they're real shy and timid and laid back, and they're like not sure. And then by the end of the night, they're just like so full of confidence.
That's wonderful.
Yeah, and I think that just explains everything that I'm trying to do right
there.
That
has to warm your heart to see that.
It does, and I think that just kind of like explains it all. Like, there's this young girl that's going through so much in her life and her family, you know, and I mean, she's had multiple surgeries. She's, yeah. you know, this girl particular, and they all have, every young girl that I've worked with.
And just it. Have so much joy.
Yeah.
That small amount right. of time. Just and the memories.
Mm-hmm. Just to see Wonderful. Them just be excited. I mean, that's what it's about. So that's what this whole thing is about. So I enjoy that the most. That's like one of my favorite ways to give back and to help with what I can do, because that's things that, you know, I love to do that can help somebody else. So that's what's fun. And just watching her family enjoy that too. And then they have those images, those photos that they can keep, the photographer gives them. So they have that for, you know, for well, forever. So it's really nice.
Well, much success on your salon, your anniversary, and your show. We'll all be watching.
Yeah, thank you so much. I appreciate you having me.
Okay, we'll see you soon.
Yep, see you soon.
Thank you for watching today's episode of Empowering Women. I would like to thank my guest, Holly Earle of The Earle Effect, and Jacqueline Capitola, owner of Jacqueline's House of Beauty Salon and Spa. I hope these women gave you information to help empower and inspire you to live your dreams and have the best life you can have. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.
Hi, I'm Gary. I work, I'm a recruiter for the 2020 Census, and I want to talk about an opportunity that only comes along once every 10 years. It's a decennial census, and we're hiring hundreds of people. No testing involved, no resumes. To apply for these jobs, the website is 2020census.gov/jobs. With great pay, flexible hours, the hours are great. You can work morning, evening, afternoons, whatever suits your schedule. And it's weekly pay, which is a great thing. And also there's paid training. And also we pay from the time you leave the house to the time you get home, along with mileage. Apply right now. Thank you so much. Again, 2020census.gov/jobs. Thank you for your time.
Oh, hey, bud.
Oh.
Where are you headed?
Just gonna hang out.
It's a school night. With Gary and Todd?
Yeah.
Not sure about those two. I've been meaning to ask you.
This is tougher than I thought.
Is there any drinking going on in this crowd?
No.
I hope not, because alcohol can lead you to say things and do things that you really wish you hadn't.
Isn't this what you're supposed to say?
I know.
So if any of your buddies ever pressure you to take a drink, just tell them you promised your dad you would.
I'd do anything to keep you safe.
Okay, I will.
I hope this is working.
I promise. Love you too, Dad.
They really do hear you.
Brian.
Yeah?
So start the conversation even before they're teenagers.
Good idea.
For tips on what to say, visit underagedrinking.samhsa.gov. A message from the Substance Abuse and Mental Health Services Administration.
What do you do for the public access TV station, BPTV?
Well, whenever Dave needs a volunteer, I originally got onto this. I came down to ask Dave to put a sign for the Rotary Club Pancake Festival in, and so I needed some volunteers and said, hey, I got some time. And you know, my wife, we travel, and in the summer times we're not around, but it's something to do, and it keeps me busy. And I've met a lot of interesting people, and I encourage anybody that has some time or looking for something to do to come down and volunteer. I mean, learn how to run a camera, help out in the studio, whatever Dave needs, and I find it enjoyable. And it isn't something that you're volunteering where they expect you to come every Thursday at 2:00 in the afternoon. This is one of those arrangements where anybody that has some time, Dave will send you an email showing what he's going to schedule the next week, and if you have some time, you call up and say, I'll be there. And it's worked for me, and it's been fun. I've enjoyed it, and once I retired, then I volunteered here and been helping out here ever since.